Hi there, welcome to another episode of my animated series where I tell you stories about my life. The past couple of stories have been sort of funny in nature, but today's story will be more informative rather than funny. I'd like to tell you about the story of my journey from Colombia to the US and how I ultimately ended up living in Rhode Island. I think someday my kids will appreciate knowing the story of how they got here. If you didn't know already, I wasn't born in the US. My journey here started in Colombia, South America. I was born in the city of Bucaramanga, in the department of Santander. It's a small urban city located between the Andes Mountains in north central Colombia, population about 500,000, roughly half of Rhode Island, but much, much smaller in size. Dad, mom, younger sister, and I made up our family, and I remember life being normal until around the year 1990. I was about 6 or 7 when our parents came to the US in search of better jobs, as many immigrants have done for decades. But they knew it was going to be a difficult journey to an unknown land, with my mom being the only one who spoke English at the time. Instead of taking my sister and I with them, they decided to leave us with our maternal grandparents. So I'd say this is where the journey begins. Our parents coming to the US and my sister and I staying in Colombia. As it turns out, the sadness of leaving one's kids behind was too much for my mom, so she came back to Colombia for us just after a month or so. There, we lived for about another year, and eventually in early 1992, we went back to Massachusetts with her to chase that American dream everyone talked about. I have memories of that time we landed in Boston and came out to the arrival section in Logan Airport and saw my dad at the end of the escalator. I also remember my dad getting lost leaving Logan and driving around Boston for like 2 hours. We didn't get home till like 2 a.m. Remember kids, this was 1992. There was no cheap commercial GPS and only rich people had cell phones at the time. So my dad was only relying on his memory and I think like a printed out map. My parents had settled in the town of Leominster, Massachusetts. That's because one of my dad's sisters was already living in Fitchburg, the town next over. Shout out to my tia Ophelia and Said. Hello. Since family had already settled in the area, the move from Colombia to Massachusetts was the logical choice. The first apartments we lived in were called Riverside, and they were nothing special. Only one-bedroom apartments, as I recall. My sister and I kind of just hung out in our apartment, doing our best to learn English by watching TV and taking in the new world around us. I do remember the neighbors were really nice to us. I'm pretty sure we learned basic English in less than 6 months by watching a lot of PBS shows. Sesame Street, Mr. Rogers, Lamb Chop, Reading Rainbow, all the good classics. Man, those were some awesome shows. I used to love Saturday morning cartoons as well. We eventually moved to a much nicer apartment over at Heritage Gardens. This one had 2 bedrooms and a recreational area with tennis courts and a pool. My sister and I also enrolled in Johnny Appleseed Elementary, which was just down a few blocks from our apartment. However, I was told that I'd have to start school back in the first grade because third grade might have been too difficult without really knowing English fluently. There was no English as a second language back then, so being thrown into a school was really pushing the English learning experience to a new level. This is a major part of why when I went to college in Rhode Island, I was already old enough to legally buy alcohol freshman year. Something my friend Mario knew very well to exploit. Thank you for all those sandwiches, man. Life in Leominster in the early 90s was pretty sweet, as I recall. Hanging out at the Toys R Us in the mall. Yeah, by the way, kids, Toys R Us used to be a big retail store chain that sold hundreds of toys and video games. It was like dreamland for poor immigrant kids like your dad was once. Anyways, let me get back to the list of good memories from Leominster. So yeah, Toys R Us, going to the amusement parks, playing ice hockey with my friends Chad, Bud, and Kyle. Okay, I forgot their real names, but I assure you they sounded something like that because I think my aunt and us were the only Hispanics in the whole town. I also remember secretly calling my second grade girlfriend while hiding in the closet and telling my sister that if she told her parents, I'd never forgive her. But unfortunately, my parents were not experiencing the same happiness, and I'm sure that being away from the rest of the family played a big part in this. In 1994, my mom decided to head back to Colombia with my sister and I. As kids, we didn't really have much say in the matter. So off to Colombia, I went once again sometime in 1994. Incredibly, I had forgotten how to speak a lot of Spanish, so naturally I was forced to restart a school grade once again. I remember trying to relearn to write fluently in Spanish and making the silly mistake of writing elefante as elefante with a PH. I was around 9 years old, back in Bucaramanga, back at the same school I was in before I made the first trip to the US, but now like 20 years older or whatever. My dad has stayed behind in Massachusetts, so between the ages of 9 and like 15 years old, I'd made several trips with my sister to visit my dad. We would come during winter time mostly, because this was when the vacation time for Colombia schools happened. I guess these trips were the reason why I never stopped talking and writing in English once I moved back to Colombia. We also became really good at navigating through major airport hubs as young children without the need of any assistance from the airlines. So lots of stuff happened family-wise between these years. Our parents got a divorce, my dad eventually moved south to Florida, my mom was struggling to make ends meet in Colombia, and some of my mom's family moved to Rhode Island. Shout out to my tío Ta and his family. So I guess this is when the next phase of my journey begins. As you remember, the reason my parents initially moved to Leominster was because my dad had a sister living nearby. So you can see where this is going. Sometime in the late 90s, my mom informed us that she was making the decision to move to Rhode Island as well to stay with my uncle for a bit. In June-ish of the year 2000, my mom and sister left from Bucaramanga's airport to chase that American dream once again. I, on the other hand, did not. I had decided to stay and finish high school. I didn't want to move once again and leave my friends behind. So, as a 15-year-old or so, I made the decision to live with one of my mom's closest friends, Gloria. She was practically like a mother to me during the time I lived with her, and her son and daughter are to this day like family. You may be asking why I didn't live with my grandparents, and that's because they lived very far from my school, and so taking the bus to school from their house was something not worth doing daily. Life with Gloria was good, I was fed well, I had a roof and a bed, but eventually I became homesick and life was getting hard without my family. So later in the year 2000 or early 2001, I ended up making a trip to visit my mom and sister in Rhode Island. At the time, I wasn't sure if I'd be permanently staying in Rhode Island rather than just visiting, but my mom was still living with my uncle then, and she had plans to move into her own place with my sister. So I decided to move back to Colombia and finish ninth grade while she made this move so we could have our own place to live. Later, in 2001, while in Colombia, we made plans and arrangements for me to move to the US at the end of the year. I had tickets, a visa, and everything was all set to move. But then, September 11th, 2001 happened. My fear after this happened was that they'd close the country off and cancel my plans, but fortunately, I was allowed to fly into the US in December 2001 with no problems at customs. So there I was, 17-year-old Fabian, leaving behind all his friends, extended family, Legos, and other toys behind to start a new life in the US once again. But I was happy to be with my mom and sister, and I'd be in the same country as my dad, just in a different state further up north. In a way, it was nice that we settled in Rhode Island, which is relatively close to Leominster, because since being here, I've taken several trips north to go down memory lane and revisit some of those places my sister and I loved as kids. Most of them are gone by now, but I still have fond memories of Ponderosa, Strawberries Marketplace, Wayland Park, and what my sister and I used to call the blue and white playground. Would I have done things differently than my parents if I were in their situation? I never really thought about that until now, which means maybe not. I understand why they made all those life-changing decisions. They ultimately wanted something better for us. So I hold no grudge against them for making us travel so much as kids. I'm happy where this journey has led me, and now I'm happily raising my own family in Rhode Island. Maybe someday we'll go to Colombia together, but just as a 2-week vacation. So yeah, that's the long version of how I got here. It feels nice writing this down so that when I'm 60 years old and starting to lose my mind, I can come back to this. Yeah, I think that's it. Thanks for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed it. Leave any questions or feedback you have below. I'd be happy to reply. Take care, and I'll see you on the next episode.